hike, where they're just going to work on reaching forward. We can have them just try and touch their toes. If they can do that, we can have them grab the sides of their feet and pull, and then we can have them try and place their hands on the floor. Another way that we can do this stretch is to have them straighten their back out and try and move their chest up and forward as they stretch. This is going to push it more into the bottom part of their hamstrings. And then we can also have them pulling on their toes so it stretches their calves and through their hamstring attachment. A couple other ways that we can do pike stretching is we can have them in a stand and try and touch the floor. If they can do that, we want their hands to be flat. And if they can do that, we're going to have them flip their hands backwards and try and reach behind their feet. And then the most challenging is we're going to have them pull their head in and look at their tummy so that they get into that nice folded position. So a lot of that's going to work on their hamstring, but they might also be a little bit tight in their back. So one way that we can really push the stretch into their hamstrings and take the tension off of their back is have them place their hands on their knee and try and arch their back so that their butt sticks out and their back is nice and straight. A lot of those kiddos are going to have their hips underneath and they don't know how to release their glutes to really push their stretch into their hamstrings. So this is a great time to start developing that open position. And then that'll be about it for all of our pike stretching. All right, moving on to our conditioning focus. We are going to have some partner squats. So we have this nice inflatable ball. It's pretty flat and that's totally okay. It helps them to balance a little bit better. You're gonna have two kiddos stand back to back with the ball in between them. And so they'll have the ball in between their back and they'll push against each other and they'll try and squat together and come back up. If you only have one student in class, you can have them do it on the wall. So we're going to place the ball on the wall and here and then work on squatting. And if you have more than two students in class, the kiddos that are waiting to do this can be working on our ring toss station where we have inflatable cactuses and you can get the rings out and have them work on tossing so they're working on that hand-eye coordination. And then if the cactuses aren't out, if it's a different part of the year, we can create a ring toss. We'll have the rings available, and you can find something for them to work on tossing. And then that's it for our conditioning focus. All right, and now we're on to the skill focus for the week. So we are focusing on handstands because these guys need to be able to find their handstand and land coming out of it. They also need to be able to find a handstand and roll, and they need to be able to find handstand and press into a bridge. So we're going to work on all three variations of those handstands. And so kiddos that you're not spotting at the time can just be working on finding their handstand. You can set them on a line, have them working on finding vertical and stepping down on their dominant foot into a lunge position. With kids, when you're spotting, you can catch them in the handstand and help them figure out that roll without crashing on their back. And then as they develop along, you can get a squishy mat for them to try it on their own as long as they're finding the handstand. What you'll get a lot of times when you ask a kid to try it for the first time is that they skip the handstand, place their hand, and just roll straight out of it. So we want to make sure we're really talking to them and developing with them to find the handstand first and roll as they fall out of it. Then from the handstand into the bridge, the technique is much different than it is into the forward roll. For the forward roll, we want them to close their shoulders and lean. And for the bridge, we want them to open their shoulders the opposite direction as their feet go over. So again, you want to be spotting that, catching the handstand, and then spotting from the shoulders as they place their feet on the ground. So we're working on all three types of handstands and figuring out where the shoulders